Good morning, children. Welcome back after a long vacation. Now again we have to start with our studies. Now in the month of April, children, we have studied about the lesson number one, history. But still again I will start with the same lesson, that is history lesson number one, tracing changes through the 1000 years. Now children, in 6th standard we have studied about the ancient history. And now in 7th standard, we are going to study about the medieval history. So, in this book, the NCERT, in this book, it focuses more on the medieval history. Now, the medieval history, this period we have seen from 8th to 18th century CE, that is common era in the Indian subcontinent. And again, this period, that is the medieval history, was divided into two periods, early medieval period, which was from 8th to 18th century, and the late medieval period, which was from 13th to 18th century. Children, now to this, there was a during the medieval period, there was a art of map making, which was known as cartography. Cartography means the person who makes the map was known as a cartographer, and the art of making the map was known as cartography. So during this period we have seen the changes in the use of maps. Now first of all I will tell you, as the lesson itself, tracing changes through the 1000 years, itself suggests that in this lesson we are going to study the changes which took place during the 1000 years, that is during the medieval period. Okay, now with the help of cartography, we came to know how the invaders came to our Indian subcontinent. They got the idea how to reach the subcontinent. Okay, so the first change which we see during this period was in the use of maps. There was an Arab geographer, Al-Adrisi, who made during the period 1154 CE, common era, he made the map. He has the map which he had given. In that map you will see that the Sri Lanka is at the top and our India is at the northern part, which we expect at the up it is down, and Sri Lanka, which is in the south of our India, is at the up. And on the next page you will, in your textbook, in the next page you will see map number 2. In that map you will see Sri Lanka is down and our India, the northern side, is at the top. Means that map is exactly the same, the map which we are studying nowadays. And that map, another next map, was by the French cartographer, that is in 1720s. So the changes in the map number 1 and in the map number 2, you can see the changes, yes or no? So this was the first change which we see during the medieval period. So children, one more change in the map number 1, you will see that the Kannauj is marked in Uttar Pradesh, and the map number 2 was really made after, was made after 600 years after the map number 1. And in map number 1, you will see that the places are marked in a Arabic language. So children, in both the maps, you will see the changes, how the changes were done during this period. So this was the first change which we see, that is the change in the uses of map. Now, okay, the second change, you will see the old, new and the old terminologies. Now, in this period, children, the different terms were used by the different people to explain a term. For example, during the medieval Persian, for example, it was different from the modern Persian. The difference is not just regarding the grammar and the vocabulary, but the meaning of the word also changes. For example, we can see the term Hindustan. Hindustan, it was also defined differently by the different people. Okay, now Minhaj-e-Siraj, who was the great leader, We have studied in the class number 6 about the Samudragupta's Prashasti. The word Prashasti we have studied in 6th standard. And he tried to explain about that Prashasti. And Minhaj-e Siraj, he explained that during the medieval period, the extent of the Mughal Tughlaq and the Delhi Sultanate was from the region of Punjab to Haryana. Okay, that is between the Ganga and the Yamuna, the land between the Ganga and the Yamuna. That again, Babur, he explained that the geography, the fauna and the culture of the inhabitants of the subcontinent. So, different people try to explain the term Hindustan in the different way. Then, the poet Amir Khusrau, he tried to explain the term Hindustan in a different way. He said that while the idea of geographical and the cultural entity like India did exist, the term Hindustan did not carry the political and the national meaning which associate with it India today. And now in the modern period, we call India as our country. We have named the country, in the modern period we name our country as the India. So the term Hindustan was defined differently by the different people during the medieval period. Now when you will go through your textbook, you will read the lesson thoroughly, you will come to understand how the different terms were used. So children, after this, the change number 1 and change number 2, you will read the lesson thoroughly and try to understand the concept. In the second change number 2, we have seen one more term, that is foreigner. The meaning of the foreigner has changed over the years. Now in the past, a person, a stranger who was not the part of the society was considered as a foreigner. But nowadays, today in the present, the person who is not an Indian, we call him as a foreigner. For example, a person who comes from America to India, we call him as a foreigner. But in the past, the person who was not from our society, for example, you can say a person going from Agra to Delhi, he was called as a foreigner. He was a stranger for them. So in this way, the different terms were defined differently by the different people over the years. Now we will move towards the third change, that is change number 3. Okay, so the change number 3, that is historians and their sources. Now how do we get to know about the medieval period? In class 6, children, we have studied about Harshavardhana, Gupta dynasty. So how did we come to know about these rulers? How do we come to know about the history? So there were different sources through which we come to know about the history. Now in this, how do we come to know about the medieval period? So the sources were archaeological sources and literary sources. In archaeological sources, there were coins, inscriptions, architecture, paintings. Literary sources, in the literary sources, that is after the invention of the paper, letters, teaching of saints, manuscripts, holy texts and the chronicles of the ruler. Now let us go one by one. In the archaeological sources, you know history, children, history is the study of the past, and archaeologists, through the excavations only we have come to know about the history. So first of all, during the different rulers, we have the coins. So through the coins we come to know about the history. But there were different coins according to their during their ruling periods. We have the different coins. Then second one, inscriptions. What are inscriptions? Inscriptions are the writing on the hard surface. Okay. So through inscriptions, now how do we come to know about the you can say the old monuments, building which comes under the architectures? How do we come to know about the Ashoka? How do we come to know about the Gupta dynasty? Because during, you know, in the 6th standard we have studied about Ashoka, the ruler Ashoka. He has inscribed on the Ashoka pillar. So what was that? He has written on the hard surface, and so through inscription only we come to know about the Ashoka, Gupta, Ashoka and Gupta dynasty. to know about the history, that is during the medieval period. Then let us move towards the literary sources. It comes later, that is after the invention of the paper. Okay, with the inscriptions, manuscript was also one of the record which was very much famous. Means the manuscripts is nothing but the handwritten records and on the palm leaves and all. But after the invention of the paper, we move towards the letters and all. But manuscripts were the handwritten records. So this was one of the source, major source, one of the major source, manuscripts and inscriptions. Then the teaching of the saints was also one of how the teachings. Now we have studied about Lord Buddha and Mahavira in class 6, how they used to give the preachings to the people and how they tried to encourage the people for Jainism and Buddhism. So these were also the different ways through which we have come to know about the history. Then holy texts, Ramayana, Mahabharata, and all these texts gives us the more and more information about our history. Now we have, how do we come to know about Ramayana and Mahabharata? Through the holy text only, then the chronicles of the rulers. Okay, so different rulers, after different time period, the rulers have ruled our subcontinent, that is the India subcontinent. So the inscriptions, so these manuscripts and inscriptions. Now let us come to the point. There was a term called scribes. So these word we have to study in detail. Who were scribes? Scribes were the people who have copied the manuscripts to the different, in a different way. So why? Because the manuscripts, after year and year, they became deformed and deforms gradually. So the information which was written on the manuscripts was not legible. So because the scribes have copied out that manuscripts in a different way, they have used the different script to copy down. That is the, they have copied down the different script. They have used the two, that is Natalik and Shitaka. Natalik was a script which was cursive and easy to understand, and Shikasta was a denser and more difficult to understand. But because the scribes have copied down the manuscript, now we are able to know about the history. So this was one of the major things. Now the question comes, children. Now you will see one word, archives, in your textbook. When you will go through your text, you will read this word. What are archives? Archives were the places where the manuscripts were stored properly. It was a library. So one of the famous manuscript was by Giordi Bologna, and his manuscript was written in 1356, and it was stored in the library. It was found in the libraries during 1971. Okay, so however, there were archives also to store the manuscripts. So these are the different sources through which we come to know about the medieval history. We have come to know about the medieval history. So the historians and their sources, archaeological and literary sources, has helped us too much